submit to you that all those how do they call it? In Kenya they call it worship experience. In Nigeria, other kinds of experience. Right? Why when they are singing and dancing, they are taking alcohol. People who sell alcohol and cigarette comes. There was one they were doing in Abuja, in the Eagle Square. Sorry, in the old, they call it old parade ground. Now they are there doing Jesus and me. People are, after they have danced, he has answered my prayer, he has heard me. Where's this latest one now? What's that song? How do they call it? Darling Jesus, all those stuff. What's the way they are doing it? Darling, like alcohol. So they go and take and drink and come back and dance, whatever they are doing, because the chunks do not change the heart. I have told you before, nobody can dance when they sing about judgment. And you understand, you can't dance when they sing about judgment that is coming. So this thing is a game, because what they do is, if you don't need to go to party in the night, we are going to bring party to you in the church. So what they call worship experiences is party brought to the church. Is that there is no sanctification, there is no purification. I was watching what gospel acted this morning, I mean in Nigeria. He was leading his song and I said, I just want to quote a scripture. I won't take your time, just few seconds. And I said to myself, what should they hear? Is it not the Bible? Why are you apologizing? You are apologizing because you want to quote a scripture. You are apologizing. You know why? There's a spirit that rules the gospel singing of the end times. It's not like the spirit of our fathers. It's the same spirit that ruled Babylon. It's the spirit of Babylon. And they told them, when you hear instrument of music, when you hear organized instrumentality, organized music, bow to the graven image. The gospel singing of today make the heart of man to bow to God. It doesn't reform the heart except very few people. It makes people to bow to God. How dare you sit under an atmosphere of church and you still have the love of money in your heart? It's because that place is a game. The fire of Baal keeps the loss of money intact. It keeps perversion intact. It keeps bitterness intact. It keeps everything that deprives you from making heaven intact. So that after you have died, they will say he has gone to be with the Lord. And the Lord will say, no, I have checked here. He's not here with me. He's in hell. He's not here. The church is saying he has gone to be with the Lord. The Lord is saying, no, he's not with me. Sometimes I said to myself, I wish God would just give some people few gates to travel into hell and check all these preachers. We have said they have gone to be with the Lord. They will realize that they are all in hell. The Bible says, without holiness, no eye shall see the Lord. You cannot die in sin and go to heaven, even though you are poor. You don't use titles to make heaven. You don't intimidate God with a title. He's the ancient of days. He's no respecter of persons. It's all about righteousness. It's all about holiness. It's all about intimacy with Jesus. The standards have not changed. I said the standard cannot be adjusted. Are you understanding me? That is why the devil knows. The devil knows the standard cannot be adjusted. So he raised another standard and gave to the prophets of Baal and said, give it to the church. Tell them that if they recite the sinner's prayer, they are born again. But the Bible did not say, when you recite the sinner's prayer, you'll be saved. The Bible said, when you renounce the sinner's life, you will be saved. Not when you recite the sinner's prayer. Are you understanding me? But the prophets of prayer tells you, when you recite the sinner's prayer, you are saved. Show me in the Bible what the Bible says a recitation can save a man. It's regeneration that saves a man. No recitation. Somebody called me some weeks back. I said, man of God, I want to give my life to Christ. And I asked her why. He said, I've been following you for 6 months. I'm no longer smoking. I'm no longer drinking. I'm no longer going to parties. I'm not sitting before television. And I'm serving God. Now I want to give my life to Christ. I said, you don't understand. You have already given your life to Christ. That
is why you cannot smoke. That is why you cannot drink. That's why you cannot go back the ways you are going. All you need is that you should come to church and join us in fellowship. Somebody give God a mighty shout. The Bible said there is joy in heaven when so genuinely born, get born again. Give God a greater shout in the house of the Lord. Is salvation. Salvation is by regeneration. It's not by the recitation of the sinner's prayer. It's the renunciation of the sinner's life where the Holy Ghost enter you and shut down the sin dimension, shut down the sin age, and establish the age of righteousness in your life. But the prophets of Baal cannot change you. So one person told me, I've been to every church. I still do this. I still do that. I masturbate. I fornicate. They say it's my weakness. But I sat before morning cloud. After I watched it for 1 month, I knew I was not born again. I keep watching it. Masturbation died. I keep watching it. Fornication disappeared. Now I am serving God. Give God a mighty shout. That is salvation. There's no day I've ever come on TV. I say, if you want to give your life to Christ, repeat after me. Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus. Shut up. I commend you to God and to the word of his grace, who is able to build you up and give you an inheritance among them that are sanctified. That is what I do. That is salvation. That is regeneration. May you carry the prophetic fire. I said, may you carry the prophetic fire. In the name of Jesus, write this down, have your seat. The prophetic fire of God is the antidote of Baal. The prophetic fire of God is the antidote of Baal. That's why Baal fear it. They can't stand Elijah. They couldn't stand him. The prophetic fire of God is the antidote of Baal. Baal strengthen the hands of sin. The prophetic fire of God deactivate the hands of sin. It deactivate the desire for sin. It shut down the frequency of Baal. That's how you must carry it. Some of you will carry it. It's going to be so strong that you step into a house where Baal rules. You didn't pray. You didn't do anything. You just sat down, took a cup of tea. As you go, Baal lives. In the name of Jesus, casting out demons by presence.